Hello, everybody. This is the Praetorian. I have some good news today. I finally was able to finish my story. If you guys want to check out the videos that I made on them, then you're more than welcome to. The story that I'm referring to is a blog that I did actually, and you can find that on Blogger, and you can also find it on WordPress. I go by the Praetorian on WordPress, and if you go by Roger Hansen on Google Plus, it's Roger Hansen 1969 at gmail.com. You can also check out my blog. You can also follow me if you want. You're more than welcome to do that. I'm on Twitter as well. The story that I'm referring to is called the system that we know according to timeline, and it's pretty interesting. I've found a lot of interesting facts that most people don't know. I made a 15 minute each video of everything that I wrote about it, and my next video will be, or my next story will be about socialism. This time it was about basically rich anthropologist, or no, I can't say rich businessmen who came to the United States from other countries and pretty much took over the economy. And when we talk about the New World Order and the elite and the 3%, the 10% and all that, these are the people that you're referring to. So like I said, I finished the last of my videos today, so check it out. Yesterday, whenever I did my last video, I was wanting to talk about Grenfell Towers over in the UK, and I decided not to, so that I could go with the original idea that I wanted to do. And I didn't let it go. What I did instead was postponed it for tonight. So let me get started on that. Now, a couple days ago I did a video that spoke about alternative media, and it also talked about, you know, commentators on YouTube that get on YouTube and they like to dramatize and create a lot of flair, and they get emotional and start acting all crazy and insinuate things, and that's what I really see here. You know, I was watching Kip's clips and I got the feeling that he was trying to insinuate that the building was, you know, purposely set on fire. And, you know, to be honest, that kind of stuff just gets on my nerves. There's over 75 people that were dead as a result of that fire. And you have people that are getting on YouTube and monopolizing off of it and taking advantage. It's not a story where you need to discuss controversy and conspiracy. The truth of the matter is that these people in England, that, you know, their society is so saturated with socialism that it's pathetic. The building that burned down was a social housing development. Okay, I've heard comments too about the gentrification and stuff like that, and, you know, for me, I don't see that either. The claims were that the area around the building was actually a nice area, and they had this one building in the middle of the area that was basically, you know, a slum and a ghetto. And that, like I said, it was insinuated that it could have been purposely started. Let me break something down for you, okay? These people that are in charge of the housing over there are the same as what they are here. You have a socialist non-government organization, okay, that doesn't have anybody in charge of it. Nobody's that's elected into office. And they appoint people to be in charge of that organization. Now, instead of those people doing their job, what they do is they contract out to other people to take care of those properties. Now, from what I'm hearing of the whole situation is when these people were contracted to do that job, instead of doing their job, they pocketed the money and they didn't put any money into the repairs. Well, when you do that, people don't seem to pay attention and notice that until something bad happens. And that's basically what happened. And see, that is another thing that gets on my nerves too. When something bad like this happens, instead of noticing the obvious and saying, look, we have a failed welfare state system that doesn't work, they just start talking about conspiracy theory, you know. Oh my goodness, they did it on purpose because they want to gentrify the neighborhood. No, that doesn't float my boat, you know. I say it over and over and over again that once you start down that path where you rely on welfare and you rely on a welfare state society to do things for you, then you're taking a risk. All right, now these people were living in unfit conditions, and yes, an accidental fire did start. It could have been from somebody doing drugs, it could have been from somebody's stove catching on fire. There's no telling what it was, but that's what happens. The same thing is happening here. I'm from Southern Illinois, and we have a town just south of us called Cairo, Illinois, and the federal housing HUD contracted the housing development out to subcontractors. Instead of the subcontractors going in and using the money to do renovations and take care of the property, they pocketed the money, and they started using the money for their own benefit and didn't put it into the houses. Now the entire HUD family or federal housing in Cairo is shut down because inspectors went in there and closed it down. My whole point is that we need to start realizing that this kind of society does not work. Okay? You have to realize that you have either a socialist government or you have a constitutional government. It's your choice. But you have to understand, socialism doesn't work. It will fail every time. Why do you think the Soviet Union fell and became Russia again? Because it was a socialist government that did not work. It's happening in Europe right now as we speak. It's happening in the UK as we speak. Now, a constitutional government, it's not perfect, and there's a lot about the Constitution that I disagree with, but it's a lot better than a socialist government. And you have to make your choice. Which do you want? For me, I'll go with the Constitution before I went with anything that's socialist. I've seen it. I've experienced it. I've been a victim of it, to be honest with you. I couldn't tell you in 15 minutes all the things that I had to go through concerning my ex-girlfriend and my son. You know, my ex-girlfriend ends up getting in trouble with drugs. She gets busted. I'm not living with her. I'm less than 15 miles away from the courthouse where she was supposed to go, and I was never notified. Okay? I wasn't notified until a year after it. I couldn't even go to her house because they were making threats saying that if I went out to see my son, I'd be arrested. She lives out in the country. And if my family went out there, that they would be arrested too for trespassing. And she got away with it. Then she gets in trouble, and I didn't hear about it for a year. I get a letter in the mail from the sheriff's department saying that I need to show up for court. I show up for court, and they railroad me all the way. They didn't take away my custody, okay? Or what they did is they took away my guardianship. They gave it to their grandparents, but I still can't have my son. Her parents live less than a block away from her. And that's supposed to be justice. Okay, that's the welfare system. That's what they do. They take a woman, that's a criminal, they turn them into a victim. When they can't rehabilitate them, they still screw the man over. Period. That's the way it works. It's not equal for every citizen in this country, just like it's not equal for every citizen in any country that practices the socialist government. Or this, it's not equal for any person that practices socialism at all. It's special interest groups. Gay people get rights, black people get rights, women get rights, single black women get rights, single white women get rights, single black men get rights, single black gay men get rights. Guess who doesn't get rights? The single white male. Especially if you haven't been married into the relationship. If you never married a girl and got her pregnant, I'm sorry to tell you're screwed. And you better freaking remember that if you haven't gotten a girl pregnant, keep it in your pants. And don't mess around. You better be serious about your life. If you are messing around, you better use a condom. But that's my whole issue about it. I've been working on this whole thing with the court systems too, and it's insane how they've sewn that up. They've got so much going on when it comes to juvenile court. You know, juvenile court is the worst of them all. They turn around and they hide things from the public and then use the child's privacy rights to do it. I mean, there's so much things that the general public has no clue about when it comes to child welfare. And you know, when you hear about the welfare system, you're not just talking about food stamps, you're talking about freaking DCFS, you're talking about all of those organizations. So think about that whenever you have time, and I hope I can edit a lot of this because it drives me nuts. I hope the best for those people over in England, but they're gonna have to start figuring it out. It's time to take back their country. It's time to stop being communist. You can call yourself whatever you want. Socialist, you know, socialist, social democracy, whatever, you're still a communist. Except for you're not violent yet. Well, I'm gonna get off here, and it's another good night to all of you, and I hope you're the best. Bye.